Good afternoon. Today is January 31st, 2011, and the market's closed here. The market held up better than I think most people, myself included, expected. I was thinking maybe more neutral to slightly down today, but we did get a bounce, and the S&P 500 finished up 0.75% higher here today. The two-day volume weighted average price initially acted as a little bit of a level of resistance, and that's important, of course, because Friday was the big down day, and what we were looking at basically at that point was the average price since Friday, that included Friday as well as an ongoing basis today. So you can see that that two-day volume weighted average price was pivotal throughout the day here, but we did hold above it, meaning that the average price that the market traded at over the last 2 days was in this area about 128.37. So anyone who bought below that on average is a winner. Well, obviously anyone who bought below that, but the average long is in a winning position, whereas the average short would be in a losing position. So it's one way to look at it, but obviously the market is lower than where it was on Friday, and we are still holding the rising 20-day moving average. We look down at a shorter term time frame here. We can see that this support continues to hold down at about 127, 127 and a quarter. So that's going to be the big level for this week. Now, anytime we see the market kind of put in a higher high, and then it looks like maybe it's going to drop, we could, you know, look at the possibility of a head and shoulders pattern forming here as well. Whether or not we form a head and shoulders pattern really isn't the point. What's more important is just that we continue to hold above 127. If we hold above that level, then we still want to look at this market as in an uptrend and maybe going to consolidate more through time than by a price pullback. But obviously there's, you know, a heightened sense of nervousness, I think, amongst people with the world, you know, with Egypt and that. But, you know, overall, the market remains in an uptrend. So even with that big volume, the average price of the last 2 days was at 128.37. So that's, and we're above that level. So we're above the average price when that big volume came. So you can't look at it so one-dimensionally, I think, that is the volume. So again, we hold on a closing basis above the rising 20-day moving average. And if we break below 127 and a quarter, 127 and stay there, then I think we have to be a lot more defensive. Now is the time for a heightened sense of caution overall. The NASDAQ held up as well. It's, you know, kind of holding this 55 and a half-ish area. So you can look really at this market as range bound. I mean, some people might call that a double top. Some people might call that just you know, an area of support. It's and that's really what it is we're trading be some important support and resistance in the near term, and a break of that range would be reason for you know, to take it seriously. Basically back below 55 and a half, we are below a declining 5-day moving average, so we don't want to see that. Obviously that basically means that you know, as I often say, intermediate term, guilty till proven innocent. I think it's really more neutral till proven innocent here, because the primary trend is still higher, but it definitely represents an area where we want to be more cautious. The Russell 2000, obviously we know the bigger level of support is down just under $77 a share. Let's just call it 76.80. Getting below and holding below about 76.80 would do, I think, some further damage to this Russell 2000. But we had broken that uptrend line. We have a lower high. We don't have a lower low. Breaking below that, then it's, you know, time to look at this market with a little different lens and say, you know, it still falls into context though of this bigger prior level of resistance on the weekly time frame. So even if we break below that 77, maybe what are we going to get down to? Maybe 75, where this prior bigger level of resistance will be tested as support. So it's difficult to become outright bearish in this type of environment. The semiconductors were up a penny today, but they were up and they did, you know, start to stabilize here a little bit from Friday's sell-off. This group actually didn't close above that two-day volume weighted average price. It was the weakest today on a relative basis, and, you know, relative to Friday's price action, but, you know, it was only up 0.03%, obviously a penny. Near term, this is looking like an important level, 34.60. I wouldn't necessarily buy above that level, but again, here's another market that might be just consolidating a little bit through time. The financials appear to be doing that, consolidating through time. 16.20 is the bigger level in here that does continue to hold. So the good news is we have a clear level. Now, Is it a run out and short it below 1620? I don't think so. There could be a good little FAS or FAZ trade in there when that occurs, but you want to manage the risk very carefully, obviously, because we still have a rising 50-day moving average, and we have some other levels that prior resistance at $16 a share from late last year that might still offer support, and we've got a rising 50-day moving average below that as well. So. A lot of uncertainty here in the near term, and that means you just kind of take it slow. There's some great action in some of the individual names, and that's really where this focus should be, I think, is in the individual stocks and looking for the low risk entry points and managing the risk aggressively.